put Dior's on my feet. This Friday, Yeat released his fourth studio album, 2093, and the first impressions of many across different social media platforms are not good. People say that the sound is boring and not diverse enough throughout the album, or simply calling it mid. So, in today's video, we will look at the different reasons people hate on the album and what people say who actually like it. 45 seconds, you wonder who are, who doesn't. Yeah, and it's way too far, gonna save that shit, I won't touch it. Begging for shotgun, break it, bad like buckets. Hey guys, and welcome back to Rap Host Nation, your favorite music channel on YouTube. Before we start, please make sure to like and subscribe if you enjoy our content. We really try to produce good content that stands out from other music channels on YouTube. So, if you like our stuff, we would be very thankful for your support. With 2093, Yeat continues his musical path in his own rap subgenre, which is best described as rather dark, villain-type rap, with many experimental aspects as distorted beats and unconventional melodies, combining elements of trap with elements of techno music. Over the past years, Yeat gained a big amount of recognition and new listeners, mostly driven by some of his songs blowing up on TikTok. And this ultimately leads us to the first reason for the disliking of the new album. His sound blew up on TikTok, not just because people liked it so much, but also because the fact that his own style of music was perfect for videos where mostly the beats of his songs created a fitting atmosphere for epic edits. There were edits about football, basketball or MMA everywhere, with Money So Big or Flawless blasting in the background. In the first listens of the new album, we clearly hear that he developed his sound. It is no longer just beats that are made to be on your For You page, and there are beats that are much more experimental and have more depth to it, like in But The Earth as an example. There are still some editable songs, how we would call them, such as Stand On It featuring Future, but overall his music changed with this project, as it should. I mean, it's only natural and good that an artist develops his music, but it is a fact that many Yeat listeners only came because of these songs that were all over TikTok, and these fans are now obviously not happy because they expected a different sound. The second point why people don't like the new album is as simple as it gets. See, even though we just talked about how Yeat's sound on the new project developed, it is still his own type of rap, as described in the beginning. So, with Yeat getting bigger these past years, there was also a new sound of rap coming up. I mean, everyone should agree when I say that Eminem and Yeat don't make the same music, but we still call both of them rappers. What I'm trying to say by that is that rap no longer is just one style of music. There are various different sounds within this genre called subgenres, and Yeat really made his own. There are people who put that Yeat sound in close relation with the whole opium style of rap, or just simply calling it a successor of the SoundCloud era, but it is safe to say that there's no other style that is identical to that form of rap. This information is important because when Yeat started to blow up, so was his style of rap, and after him making this sound popular, many rappers started to follow that way he paved. Because of that, it is now very common for us listeners to hear this type of beats and rapping. That's a problem nearly all different subgenres in music are facing. People hear a new type of sound and really starting to like it because it's something new and different, but because of that, more and more people starting to listen to that new style, and more artists try to use the style for their music. This cycle is currently also happening with Yeat's sound, and it's nothing he can be blamed for, it's indeed very natural in the music industry. Because of this problem, many people now call the album mid, but it not really is the fault of Yeat. I mean, he made that sound. It is rather a problem of the listeners who have listened to so much different songs in that subgenre that they no longer get satisfied with this type of music. In conclusion, it is safe to say that there isn't just slander and hate for the new album. If you go on Twitter or Instagram, many day one Yeat fans already calling this a classic and think that this project is Yeat going back to the sound he came from before going insanely viral on TikTok. They also criticize the fans that know Yeat from TikTok, that they don't really know the sound that Yeat made, and that they are only hating because he didn't drop Flawless Part 2 or Sorry About That Part 2. Another comment on the album we saw very often is people saying that 2093 will have the same effect on listeners as Whole Lotta Red from Playboi Carti had. For these who don't know, Carti received a lot of backlash when he first released his last studio album, but as time went on, people more and more started to like that new sound of Carti, and the album is now considered his best album ever made. Cash Carti fans, please don't roast me in the comments. And many fans believe that the same will happen with Yeat's album. So, with that being said, that leads us to our own opinion. And after listening to the album a couple of times, we share the same perspective as most day one Yeat fans. We don't consider ourselves big Yeat fans, but it is safe to say that after hearing it more than once, it's a really nice development to his older albums, with the fact that he still stayed in his own lane and didn't switch up his style completely. And that's how a new album should be in our eyes. We also think that the album will grow on many rap listeners, and at least when the first TikTok edits with the new Yeat sound are starting to go viral, the hate should stop very fast. That brings us to the end of this video. We really hope you enjoyed, and please let us know in the comments what you think of the new Yeat album 2093. Don't forget to like and subscribe and share this video with your grandma so she stays updated on all relevant things in the universe of rap.
Scoop, scoop-de-whoop, whoop-de, whoop-de, whoop-de-scoop.